This is Dr. Aruna Chaturvedi from the Department of Information Technology. The subject which I am taking is Programming and Problem Solving through Python. The topic which I cover today is Decision Making Statements in Python. Decision making statements are basically some statements in which you can evaluate certain conditions which are occurring during execution of a program. And on the basis of the evaluated value of a condition, you specify some actions which are to be taken according to the actions required to be taken in a program. So decision structures basically able to evaluate multiple expressions which are going to produce either value as true or false. You have to determine that which action to be taken when the statement is returning the value is true and which all actions are to be taken when the result is false. So these are required when the sequential flow is not existing in a program. The program need to take some different action on the basis of certain conditions. So whenever some conditions are lying in making a program or designing a program and accordingly you have to take some actions, you are provided with certain control flow structures or decision making statements which we can use in Python. So while writing a program, we always need the ability to check the conditions and then change certain course of actions. Like if some condition is true, what action is to be taken? You can specify like this. So whatever condition you mention over there, it returns either true or false. You can just look at this diagram. It's a flow chart. What is going on? So flow of statement is coming from here. You have written certain set of statements. The moment the control reaches over here, there is some condition written by the programmer. If this condition can return two values, one is true, another is false. You have to check if the condition is resulting to true, what all statements are to be executed. And when the condition is returning false, what all to be done? Whether you have to take an exit directly or some other actions are to be taken. So this is how the decision making statements flow of execution happens in a program. With this diagram, you will be able to easily understand that it's not a sequential flow. In this, on the basis of conditions, the actions can be different. Depends upon a programmer what actions the programmer will be going to write in a program, that what action is to be taken when condition is true and what action is to be taken when condition is false. So there are three types of control flow structure or decision making statements available in Python. One is if, another is if else, and third is nested if. If statement means which consists of Boolean expression. Boolean expression means which returns true or false. So if condition is true, it will take certain set of actions. Otherwise, it will not be going to take any other action because you will not be able to mention over here. Whereas in case of if else, if condition is true, you can write certain set of actions. And if in case it is false, you can go to else statement. It provides you else statement and you can take certain other actions which are to be taken in case the condition is false. You can have a nested if statement also, wherein you can nest more than one if inside the parent if or outer if block. One will see all. This is an example of simple if. It is similar to that of other language. The if statement contains a logical expression using which data is compared and a decision is made based on the result of the comparison only. How we use it? We simply write if and then expression over here, and this colon symbol should come over here. The moment this condition is true, these all statements will be going to get executed. So this depends upon the condition. If Boolean expression evaluates true, then the block of statement inside that statement is executed. If it evaluates false, then the first set of code after the end of the if statement will be going to execute it, which will be written over here, not within the else block, because it is not having any else block. It is just saying that if condition is true, take this action. If it is false, it is not mentioning anything over here. So be careful about this thing. So in this, what happens? This flow of statements are coming from here. In this way, here the condition will be going to check. If it is true, these all statements will be going to get executed. If it is false, it will come out of the if block and execute the next statement, which is written over here outside the if block. This is one of the example. In this example, I have taken one variable var1, the value is 100. I am checking if var1 is true, then it will return that I got a true expression value and print whatever the value is stored in var1. Then var2, if it is 0, it will check if the value initialized to var2 is 0, it will check whether it exists or not. If it returns true, it will going to print that got a true expression value. Then it will print, and then this is the statement which is outside the print block, so it will be going to get executed later on. So what happens over here? It will come over here. Var1 is having 100 value, so it means it will be returning true, and I'll get the output as got a true value for var1, and it will return the value of var1, and then the output will be example of simple if. It means the statement will be reaching over here. Otherwise, statement will not be going to reach over here. And as var2 is having false value, it will not be going to execute this statement. Another example is to check whether the entered number is even or not. So I have accepted the number from the user. The user will enter a number over here. As I have used input statement, I have converted this into integer type, and then I am just checking whether the divisibility of this number with 2 is 0 or not. If it is 0, it will print number is even. So you can look at the output. I have entered 5, no output is over there, whereas as I entered 6, it is displaying number is even. This is one of the other example. In this you can see this is a program to print largest amongst three number. I have accepted three number, enter A, B and C, converted all the three numbers into integer. Comparing if A is greater than B, and here we can combine two expressions together using and. A is greater than C. If both are returning true, it will return A is greatest. If B is greater than A as well as B is greater than C, it will return B is greatest. If C is greater than A, C is greater than B, it will return C is greatest. No else part is over here. I entered three numbers. It will not execute first one. It will check B is greater than A as well as C. So it will return B is largest. So now we see if we want to take some action when the statement is returning false, then we are having two ways. One is we can write condition over here. If it is true, we'll take these all actions. Otherwise, we'll write else colon, and we can write the else block also. We can also have multiple conditions together to be checked one after another. If one is true, it will take these all actions. Elif. If we are having another condition, we will use elif. Elif, another condition, if it is true, it will execute block 2. Otherwise, if condition 1 and condition 2 both are false, it will go to else block and execute the else block over here. So here box bracket means optional, it is not necessary, but if it is required, you can have multiple conditions checked over here also. So one by one, we'll see the example of these. This is the example. An else statement can be combined with if statement. An else statement contains the block of code that executes if the conditional statement and the if statement resolves to 0 or false. Fine. Otherwise, it will be going to execute if statement. Else statement is optional, and there could be at most only one else statement following if. If you are having multiple condition, then you have to go for elif. So this is the syntax: if, condition, colon, statements, else, colon, statements. This is a flow chart. Here the flow is coming in this way. Here there is a condition. If this condition is returning true, this code will be going to be executed. If this condition is returning false, then this code will be going to be executed. So this entire will be if block. Once it will come out of if block, it will start it executing the statements which are written over there as a normal statement. Here is an example. Here I am having the value of var1 is 100. I am checking if it is true, it will return that the value of var1 is this and the expression is true. Else, it will say that the value is false and it will return again the value of var1 as that this is the false value it is containing. Now again I am having where to value as 0. It will check whether it is having some true expression value or not. If it is having, it will return, it will print the if block. Otherwise it will go to else block and say that the expression is false, and then print the value of where to also. And this is a normal statement which is outside the if block. It will be going to execute this also, and I have mentioned over here that example of if else. So see the how the output will come. It will check where one is holding value as 100, so that's why it has evaluated this expression as true expression and the value it is holding is 100. It will not go to else block. Whereas when we come to where to, it will not go to if block, because where to is holding false value, and it will directly come to else block, and from else block it will display that got a false expression value. The value of where to is 100 is 0, sorry, and it will, as it is display that example of if else, as I have mentioned, it's outside the if block, so it will be going to print it as it is. This is another example. Here I am checking whether a person is eligible to vote or not. So I have to check in both ways. I'll accept the value from the user, convert it into integer type, check whether it is greater than equals to 18. If yes, it will say it is eligible, you are eligible to vote. Otherwise also it will say you are not eligible, you have to wait. So I have given a value as 45, so it mentioned that you are eligible to vote. Whereas here, this is an example to check whether a number is even or odd. So I have accepted the number from the user, converted this into int, check the divisibility by 2. If it is 0, it will display that number is even, otherwise odd. This time, the number entered by me is 7. 7 is not divisible by 2, so that's why it will go to else part and display number is odd. So this is example of if else. We'll see few more examples. I hope you understand. Now this is where we learn how to use elif. If you are having more than one condition, you can check multiple conditions also whether they are true or false. If they are false, they'll go to another condition and check their value of another condition. So if expression 1 is true, this statement will be going to be executed. Otherwise, if it is false, it will go over here, check this expression. If this is true, it will execute this statement. Otherwise, it will go and check this condition. If third expression is true, it will execute this statement. And if all the three are false, then it will go to else block and execute this statement. So this is the benefit of elif statement, that you can check multiple conditions in one go. If any one of them is true, it will take action accordingly. We will look at the example. This is a flowchart. If this condition is true, then it will take this, execute this statement. Otherwise, it will fall off and check to another condition. If this condition is true, then it will take these all actions. Otherwise, it will fall down and check this condition. If this condition is true, it will take these all actions. So this is also known as ladder if. Here I have accepted the marks from the user and checking if the marks are lying within range 85 to 100. I'll mention that the grade is A, otherwise between 60 to 85 grade is B plus, otherwise between 40 to 60 grade is B, else the grade is C, or otherwise if the marks are less than 30 then you are failed. So here as I entered 67, so 67 is lying within this 60 to 85. That's why the output I received is your score grade is B plus. This is another example. In this again, I have accepted a number from the user and I am checking if this number is equals to 10, it will display this. If it is equals to 50, this. If this is equals to 100, this. Otherwise, it will say it is neither 10 nor 50 nor 100. As I entered 50, it has printed that the value is equals to 50. One more example you can see. This example, I am having value of where as 100. Within this now I am again reinitializing the value of where is 200. I am checking if the value is true, it will return that the value of where is 200. Otherwise, if it is 150, it will check print that the value is 150. If it is 100, it will print that the value is 100. Otherwise, if it is neither 200, 150 or 100, it will go to else block. So as the value I have initialized before the if block was 100, that's why this third block has been executed and mentioned that the value of where is 100, and the last statement will always be going to get executed because it is outside the if block. This is another example. In this I am given certain range of percentage, accordingly some grades are mentioned. So looking at this, it is easily clear that you have to use elif statements for this because you are having multiple conditions to be checked. So in this example, I accepted the marks and checked according to the criteria given over there, and accordingly I have printed the grade also. So in this, as I entered 78 is lying within this block, and that's why the grade B is being printed over here. Now you are given certain assignments. I just want you people to practice on these all assignments. So these all assignments are over here, and you just go through these all questions and solve it. If you are having any issue, you can ask me. Like I'll just explain all those questions to you so that you can do it. So with this, I'll just the questions, and if you are having any problem in any of the question, put it in description box. I'll get back to you and solve all the questions query. Whereas in coming slides, I will be providing you the solution of all the questions also. You can wait for my next video also, in which you will be going to see the solution for each and every questions. Thank you. Have a nice day.